end of this video is to give you some practice in Illustrator of playing with forms using icons and simple shapes to play with positive and negative space and the dynamic that creates. So for example, in this food and wine poster, the prongs of the fork being substituted by the wine bottles and those shapes playing with each other in that positive and negative space. In this example of a Canon advertisement, the white and the red, seeing the figures, the faces. And this is one of my favorite posters, but this play between doves and peace, being in the waves and the foam of the waves versus in the sky. All right, so here's kind of the finished example that we're using three different simple icons from Noun Project. A bird and two types of trees, and starting to use our tools in Illustrator to create layers and that play between foreground and background. All right, so if we use our artboard tool, we can draw an artboard. And if we use our selection tool, the black arrow, we can grab the icon and we can do Command-C, C, like cat, and Command-V, which paste it, so that gives us a tree. If we hold down Shift, we can constrain the proportions and without stretching, grow the tree by pulling its corner. Remember, if you pull from the sides, you're stretching it. Even if you hold down, well, actually, if you hold down Shift and pull from the sides, it will still constrain proportions. But best practice is from the corners and hold down Shift. All right, so you want to get used to using your keyboard, Command-C, Command-V, start to layer, create smaller shapes, so you're making a forest, thinking about the larger shape that these trees are making. So they're making kind of a block of forest, right? Okay, so let's say you've played with adding some black. Now this time, turn your icon white, so you'll go to your fill, select white, which is all the way in the top left, so diagonal from black, and it's all F's as your hex code. And this time, you can start to work with the white shapes and start to add scale. Remember, if your screen goes with an overlay on it, look up to see if you have breadcrumbs, if you've gone inside a layer. Keep erroring out until you can select things normally. Okay, so you can also play with, what if there's a tree up at the top? You can take a tree, go to the corner, use your rotate. What if it was turned upside down to make a counter form? All right, so you need to play with that icon. Make sure that we give credit to the icon creator. So if we zoom in, this is a tree from the Noun Project by Jacqueline Fernandez. All right, so now let's play with another simplified tree. So we'll draw another artboard. We'll grab our Christmas tree icon. Okay, remember, scale from the corners, use Shift to get there. Let's say for this one, we want to do something similar to here where we're adding shapes behind something that is the solid white. So in this case, I could make white inside with a black outline. That way I can see the shape. And now when I'm adding black trees behind it, changing the scale, I can start to see that shape that I'm making. Right, and just keep adding different kinds of sizes. This is where you'll want to use window, align, okay, object, arrange, and you have bring to front, bring forward, send backward, send to back. So remember that there's layering. So you may need to change the layer for certain items. So if I can see I can't get this tree, right? This tree keeps duplicating on top. So I would select it and say object arrange, send to back. And now it's the very back layer. Okay, so you can kind of create depth by playing with which items are in front or behind each other. All right, and make sure that you add your credit to the maker of that icon. So for this third one, you're going to also create an artboard, and we are playing with the bird icon. And on this one, I want you to experiment again with layering, but especially scale. So could you have, I'm gonna say object arrange, bring to front, and we're gonna make it white. Right, so maybe it aligns with the edge so that it's implied how there's a second bird, right? Which one is on top, which one is behind. Maybe you then also make another bird, and maybe its scale is even larger. Then you could experiment, well, what if a black shape now bled into this one? You can see I made it black, but I can't see it yet. The reason why is it's in the background. So I have to go object, arrange, bring to front. Now it's up front. You know, maybe it kind of goes in like that. Maybe you touch there. So you start to kind of build shapes and layers. Play with scale again. So look for where your lines might align. Maybe you can grab multiple items by using your selection mouse, so your arrow, clicking and dragging over what you're selecting. So now I have all of these items selected, and I can scale them all together to fit on my page. All right, so that's kind of some ideas for how you can start to just train your eye, experiment with foreground and background, this positive and negative space, playfulness, as well as get used to using your tools in Illustrator.